So, what's first? Fuck no. I quit. Now let's talk about the running joke. Do you know how many times that line is spoken throughout this 22 minutes? 10 times! They say it 10 times in 22 minutes.
We're not supposed to be doing this. I bet we're not supposed to be doing this.
Johnny still has an ID microchip implant from that time we turned him into an alpaca.
Did I tell you that everyone in this show is an asshole? By the way, that was never an episode, and that's an asshole. But knowing where Johnny...
It's time to bid farewell to Jet. And hello to your exciting new life of greed and boredom!
What? Wait, what? Octopus? What the fuck did...
...lifetime showcase, I've secured for you a job as an apprentice filing clerk in the 422nd Filing Division of the Master Filers Regiment of the Supreme Filing Battalion.
I have to do a fucking octopus!
Gee, I'd say this is getting pretty dramatic.
I went with a fucking octopus!
Of course you saved the green one. Yes, yes, yes. My friend Minty sees the world through green-colored glasses.
What? What does that even mean? I mean, the premise is our three main characters try to con kids out of their money. This could have easily turned out bad, like the Eugene Crabbe show. But instead, then they go replacing SpongeBob in the opening theme song with all of the other main characters. It wasn't funny the first time, it wasn't funny the second time, and the third one makes me revile in horror of what the Eugene Crabbe show would be like. Why is Santa Claus a pirate? Scratch that, the captain of the pirates that are stealing toys. That's like making the Easter Bunny allergic to eggs, or making Mickey Mouse a fucking hippo! You've got the first detail about the most important character in your story completely wrong.
Yes, yes, yes!
And she keeps saying that.
Oh, now I gotta dry you off. Unfortunately, I couldn't find any salt.
That kills snails, you fuck!
And taking a snail to a salt factory. Excuse me for a moment, I need to make a phone call.
Yes, Nickelodeon Studios. I've seen this terrible joke in both SpongeBob and now in The Fairly Odd Parents, where a careless pet owner thinks that salt is a good idea for a snail, and the writers think that putting them in mortal danger or killing them is funny. Do you have any insight on this?
Oh, what do you care about? All they do is crawl around, spread slime everywhere, bring home finger paint art, shouting, "Daddy, Daddy, why don't you play with me?" Well, maybe Daddy wants to be alone and bathe in his money bath! Now why don't you go play with your wooden bat? But Daddy, it's all broken and then don't get a splinter. Ha 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 ha. Sorry, I was just caught up in my thoughts. What did you want?
Why do you think it's funny killing snails with salt? But now I can see that you have other problems, so I'm just gonna leave you.
Whatever, asshole.
Chris, our bath is ready.
We're not supposed to be doing this. I bet we're not supposed to be doing this.
I don't see why it's too much for you to explain. Unless, you know, it's typical for you to pull random crap out of your ass. When the alligator... Unfortunately, the helmet is overloading, which means that it's going to blow up on his head. Please kill him. Please do the world a favor. Kill him. Kill him. Kill him. Please kill him. Kill him. Kill him!
Oh, please come over for a visit, Squidward.
Please get in my van, Squidward. It's been so long. So Zeus decides to award his captives by rebuilding the Titanic. Are you shitting me? There's no other explanation. This movie is fucking shitting me. That's not slightly offensive at all. No, just no.
Artie, His Majesty asked me to come and help you take the Titanic to the Forgotten Island.
Do you know where Froggy is?
Yes, yes, yes!
Stop saying that. Some offhand talk gives Peter a stupid, stupid idea.
Chris? There comes a time when every man looks at his son and thinks, I want to take this to the next level. Chris Griffin, will you marry me?
Dookie and Johnny discover a bunch of random fish. Johnny begins trash talking. Kinda easy to lighten the mood here, isn't it? Hey look, someone's house is on fire! His charming stupidity from the early seasons has morphed into the most hated character on the show for me. More than SpongeBob, more than Karen, and even more than Mr. Drivey to Suicide Crabs. I have to assume that the writers did that on purpose.
Yes, yes, yes!
Stop saying that. Also, some of these scenes get really frustrating. Don't take the marker. Don't take the marker. Don't take the marker.
Oh, for goodness sake, Master Blue! Who would be so stupid as to write his own name on the wall?
Don't pick up the bat! Don't pick up the bat!
Don't pick up the bat! And he picks up the bat. And Coco takes pictures of him with the bat.
Turn him towards the wheel. Turn him towards the wheel. Turn him towards the wheel. You're an idiot.
I don't believe this. Who flushes a chainsaw?
First of all.
Hey, do you know what's going on? What are we doing here? How did we get in the water?
I don't know. I really don't fucking know. On second thought, whatever the fuck he was smoking probably inspired this shit, so he can keep it.
What's this place called?
Marijuana.
Ooh, Groovinia.
No, I said marijuana. The only pony I know for sure is Razzle Frazzle because she won't stop saying...
Yes, yes, yes!
Yes, the writers are chuckling to themselves like middle school dropouts.
What's that? I can't hear you, what with all the lonely voices in my head.
Torture Squidward, Torture Squidward, Torture Squidward, Torture Squidward, Torture Squidward, Torture Squidward.
Oh, I love that part!
Hey, guys, that house is still on fire! No, seriously, it's catching the entire neighborhood on fire, and the extinguisher is missing. How do I put it out?
Rainbows, darlings, rainbows!
They aren't doing anything! And we see our villain. Yes, this has a villain, besides Bubsy's stupidity. They escape the taxi through a hole in the floor because the writers put it there, and make their way to the...
Holy whack-a-zoli!
Peter's a pedophile. Patrick leaves because, well, because all the reasons, I guess.
I'm the best pal ever!
All of a sudden, Johnny and Dookie get saved by a Deus Ex Machina. I mean, Mr. Black and Mr. White. These two are secret government agents that should not be involved with this episode.
I'd rather listen to Mr. Black and Mr. White from Johnny Test sing about Fiji than you.
And today, a mere 10 years later, obviously, 10 years ago I said that.
Thank you for restating that vital piece of information. You saw us at Poof in the intro to season 7. When he was more useless than we thought, you saw us at an even more uninspired version of him in Anti-Poof in season 8. With even fewer ideas to go through, season 9 introduced Sparky, Cosmo's long-lost twin brother. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, we're opening season 12 with Cletus, the rapping shark. This is the Fairly Odd Parents saying, end us! Fucking end us already! We're tapped for ideas! We need to keep pulling more and more characters out of our ass just to keep the show afloat! Just please, put us out of our misery! And we see our villain. Yes, this has a villain, besides Bubsy's stupidity.
The Rock almost randomly decides to free Santa.
Oh yeah, and why the fuck doesn't Larry know who SpongeBob is? Enough of this. Johnny breaks out of the gator mouth with a waterproof dental drill, because asshole.
Jump out of-
and, bye bye Sparky! But that's not how it ends. Yes it is! The episode's over! Goodbye! Sparky was wished away because no one likes him. Timmy wished him away in his dying breaths after Sparky left Timmy to die in a plane crash despite not needing a parachute. I'm done here.